Welcome class 11. We have read about vectors addition and subtraction. Now it is the turn to read about product of vectors, that is vector multiplication. So let's begin with product of vectors. Vectors are multiplied by two ways. First is called dot or scalar product, and the other one is cross or vector product. That is, the multiplication of vector is of two types. Number one, dot or scalar product. Second is cross or vector product. What does it mean? Suppose two vectors are A and B. If it is written like A dot B, by putting a dot, we are multiplying the vectors, and we get the multiplication as A B cos theta. Theta is the angle between the two vectors. This A magnitude of vector A, B is magnitude of vector B, and cos theta, theta is the angle between two vectors and their cosine. So A B cos theta, this whole product is a scalar, and we have put dot here, that's why its name. Dot is put and product is scalar. So look how this is called dot product or scalar product. If the question is asked, define a scalar product, then you have to write like this. Why this is called dot? Why this is called scalar? Because this product AB cos theta, this is scalar. What about cross or vector product? If the two vectors which are at angle theta, they are multiplied by putting cross here, and we get the resultant, this AB sine theta into unit vector. AB sine theta is a scalar, but this unit vector, which is in a plane perpendicular to both A and B, makes this product as vector. That's why this total multiplication is a vector, that's why its name is vector product, and we have used cross here, so its another name is also cross product. Today we will learn about dot or scalar product. Let us discuss. As we have read here, that dot product of two vectors is the multiplication of magnitude of one vector and other vector, also the cosine of angle between them. The whole multiplication AB cos theta is a scalar. How will you interpret, what is the geometrical interpretation of this AB cos theta A dot B? Look, how will you draw two vectors? Suppose one vector is A, its name is suppose OP, and this vector is A. Another vector at theta angle from A, this vector is B, suppose its name is M hat, and this is B vector. How to find the dot product of these two vectors? We have read dot product is AB cos theta. If from the vector A, from its head, a perpendicular is drawn on the vector B, suppose this point is N, can you say what is the name of this ON? We have read in the previous video that ON is the projection of resolution of vector A in the direction of vector B. What will be ON? You can see here that ON can be written as A cos theta. Look, this will be the right angle, ONP. Then what will be ON? A cos theta. And another vector which is B in the same direction, then what is A dot B? Therefore, you can write this A dot B as projection of vector A on the B, that is A cos theta, and vector B itself, that is B. What is this? A cos theta, AB cos theta. Similarly, if the vector A is here, this is same vector A, and the vector B is shown at the angle theta. This is the vector B. This is the point M. Now, it can be taken, resolution of vector B can be drawn on the vector A. How will you draw? From the top of head of vector A, vector B, you will draw the normal. Look here, from the top of vector A, you have drawn normal. Here, you, from the top of vector B, you have drawn normal. So, from the triangle OMP, look, this is the B cos theta. Now, what is dot product? A into B cos theta. So, here, this is A dot B equal to A into B cos theta. What I mean to say, if the two vectors are at an angle theta, then their dot product is any of the projection of one vector on the other multiplied. Here, A cos theta is a projection of vector A multiplied with the magnitude of B. Here, B cos theta is the projection of vector B on the vector A. So, B cos theta is multiplied by the magnitude of A. So, AB cos theta, this is the dot product. Now, what are the properties of dot product? Since the dot product is AB cos theta, then first property that two perpendicular vectors dot product is 0, and it is simple because cos 90 is 0. So, the question is also asked that if the two vectors have their dot product 0, what is angle between them? 90 degree. If the two vectors are at 90 degree, what will be their product? Dot product, then it will be 0. So, always learn that the reverse of the given statement can also be asked. So, if the two vectors are at 90 degree, then cos 90 will be 0. So, their dot product will be 0. And if the dot product of two vectors is 0, then these two vectors are perpendicular. Second, if the two vectors are parallel, so you know for theta equal to 0, cos 0 equal to 1, therefore A dot B will be simply AB because cos 0, 1. So the dot product of two vectors is maximum. This is AB. Similarly, for theta equal to 180 degree, you know cos 180 is minus 1. So, what can you write here? That A dot B, if the two vectors are anti-parallel, then the product will be minus of their multiplication of magnitudes. Vector product, this dot product may be negative for theta less than 270 and greater than 90 degree, because for these variation of angles the cos value is negative. Another property that you know about the unit vectors, which are represented as I, j, k, and I is the unit vector in the direction of x axis, j in the y along y axis, and k along z axis. So, next property, how will you write that I dot j? equal to j dot k equal to k dot I, whatever is taken, what will be 0. Why will you write 0? Because the angle between any two axes is 90 degree and I dot j will be ij cos theta cos 90 will be 0. So this is dissimilar unit vectors. If they are multiplied, their dot product is taken, then it will be 0. What about if a vector is multiplied by itself? This is called self product of a vector. A vector is making 0 degree with itself. So what will you write here? This will be a cos 0, cos 0 is 1. So it will be simply a square. So it is also, it can be said that self product of a vector is always the square of its magnitude. So in this way, the properties of vector, dot product, their properties can be learned. Why should we learn dot product? Because it is applied, it is applicable to know what is the angle between two vectors. You know, we have read A dot B as AB cos theta. Then what is the angle between A and B? To determine it, we learn dot product. So cos theta will be equal to dot product of two vectors upon AB. What are AB? The magnitude of one vector into magnitude of other vector. So to find angle between two vectors, we learn dot product. Finally, if a vector is given in, its coordinates are given in three dimensions, like vector A is given ax I cap plus ay j cap plus az k cap. Similarly, a vector B is given bx I cap plus by j cap plus bz k cap. Remember, what are ax, ay? Ax is the part of vector A along x axis. This is the resolution we have read in the previous video. Similarly, part of vector A along y axis and along z axis. Now, if A dot B is asked, then how will you multiply? Look here. By simple multiplication, if you are going to multiply this axi with all these three terms, then I dot I, what is here? Look, if I dot j, j dot k, k dot I is 0, then cos theta is 90 degree. What about I dot I? You know, I dot I equal to j equal to k dot k. What will you write? Like the self product. What is the magnitude of I and I? Both j, I, j, k have 1. So it will be equal to 1. Look here. What will be I dot j? This will be 0. So if you multiply this with only the term having I, then you will get the product as this A dot B. I am describing you how will you write A dot B. Look, if this is multiplied by AXI multiplied by BXI, you will get AX into BX because I dot I will be 1. Now, if you multiply AXI into BYJ, I into J will make 0. Look here, I dot J is 0. I into k will make 0 because they are perpendicular. So what is the method if the vectors are given in this form, ax, ay, az or bx, by, bz? Simple multiplication. Multiply I term with the I term, j term with the j term and k term with the k term. What will be the multiplication here? Look, this will be ax into bx, this will be ay into by, and this will be finally az into BZ. This will be the vector multiplication. And what are you getting here? You can check again that these are the scalars. That's why this dot product is also called the scalar. Finally, after addition, you will get a scalar quantity. Now, these are the properties of dot product. Let us discuss another property, that this is asked that show that dot product is commutative. You know what is the meaning of commutative? Commutative means A dot B will be same as B dot A. How will you prove? You know, A dot B, if the vector A and this is the vector B and angle between them is theta, then what will you write? It is A dot B. This implies that A dot B equal to magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B into cos theta as per its property. But what about B dot A? You go from B towards A. What is this angle? If this is theta, this angle will be 360 minus theta. Then what will you write for B dot A? B dot A will be written as B A into cos 360 minus theta. Again, learn some trigonometry, that cos 360 minus theta is cos theta. So what can you write here? This B A cos theta, both are same. That's why AB cos theta and BA cos theta both are representing A dot B, and B dot A both are same. Similarly, you can also prove that this vector product is also associative over the addition. What does it mean? That if a vector A dot B plus C is given, how will you write it? A dot B plus A dot C. Let us discuss few examples related with dot product. We know dot product is used to find the angle between two vectors. So let's discuss the first example here. Find the angle between vector A and vector B. You know, dot product of two vectors is A dot B. So A dot B is AB cos theta. What is A and B? Modulus of vector A and B. Here, you know what is vector A? This is what will be the modulus of A. Under root A x square plus A y square plus A z square. What is A x? Coefficient of I, that is 1. So what will you write? 1 square, that will be 1, plus a y 2, 2 square is 4. This is minus 1, minus 1 square is again plus 1. So what is this? Under root 6. Similarly, we can find the magnitude of B. So what is this here? Under root 1, 1 and 4. So it will be again root 6. 1, this 1, this is 2 square 4, minus 2 square 4. You know, modulus is always written with the positive sign. So never get confused that this is minus 2, so you will write minus 4. Minus 2 square will be plus 4. So this will be root 6. What will be cos theta? Cos theta will be A dot B. So first you find A dot B. Look here, what will be A dot B? I told earlier that multiply I with I terms, J with J terms and K with K terms. What will be I into minus I? That will be minus 1. 2J into J, this will be plus 2, because J dot J, I dot I, they are unit vectors, magnitude 1. Here minus k and minus 2k. What will be this? Plus 2. look here, this is 2j and j, so it is 2. This is minus, minus will become plus, and this is 2. So what is here? It is 2 to 4 minus 1, that is 3. So a dot b is 3. Finally, cos theta, from this relation, what is cos theta? A dot b upon mod a mod b, that is root 6 into root 6. What is a dot b? 3. So 3 upon 6. Cos theta is 1 by 2. What will be theta? How much? 60 degree. So for these two angles, these two vectors, what is angle between them? 60 degree. Look the second example. I hope this example will make you clear how to find the angle between two vectors using this dot product. This is the main application. Let us do the second question. Find the angle made by vector A, 7i plus 0, j plus 7k from x, y and z axis. Now how will you find this vector is making what angle with these three axes? You know, vector A is given 7i plus 0, j plus 7k. Then what will be modulus of this vector? How will you write A? Under root this square, 7 square plus 0 square plus 7 square. What it will become? 49 plus 0 plus 49. So it will become 7 root 2. And how can you compare this vector with the AX, AY, AZ form? AXI, what will be AX? 7. You know, this vector can be written as A equal to AXI cap plus AYJ cap plus AZK cap. What is AX? Look here. AX can be written as A cos theta. Suppose this vector makes angle theta 1 with the x axis. So I have written cos theta 1. How will you find this cos theta 1 as AX upon A? What is AX? Look, compare 7. How will you write here? This AX is 7 upon A. What is A? 7 root 2. The 7, 7 will be cancelled. So cos theta 1 is 1 upon root 2. That means theta 1 is how much? 45 degree. Similarly, what about AY? You will find AY will be 0 by comparison. So what will be cos theta 2? You can write here cos theta 2 will be AY upon A, that is 0. It means theta 2 is 90 degree because cos 90 is 0. Finally, this 7 is also AZ. So whatever is AX, same is AZ. So theta 3, suppose this vector A makes theta 3 angle with the Z axis. So theta 3 will also be 45 because you will write cos theta 3 as AZ upon A, same you will get. So I hope that this vector A makes what angles with x, y, z axis, it will be clear. Next question, look, prove that A and B are perpendicular. If A square plus B square equal to C square and vector A equal to vector B plus C. Look, this is the question. How will you prove that A and B are perpendicular? Given A square plus B square equal to C square and A plus B equal to C. How will you write? Since A plus B equal to C, it is given. Take the dot product on both sides. This is the application that you can write this a plus b dot a plus b, taking dot products on both sides. Here you can write c dot c. Now open the bracket. So this a dot a, you will get self product. A dot a will be a square, plus this will be b dot a, so this will be b dot a, you will write here. Then this will be a dot b, so plus you will write a dot b. And finally this b dot b, so you will write here this b dot b. And what will be here, this c dot c will be c square. This a dot a will be a square. What will be this b dot a dot b, both are vector product is commutative, so you can write here this 2 a dot b. Look here, this is the only magnitude and these two are vectors, these two, plus here this b square, and this is equal to c square. Now you can write here a square plus b square. What a square plus b square? It is given a square plus b square equal to c square. What will you get here? If a square plus b square is c square, then this c square will be cancelled. You will get only 2 a dot b equal to 0. Look, what are you getting? A dot b 0, that means cos theta is cos 90, that is theta is 90 degree. How can you write a dot b 0? That means a b cos theta, and since a dot b 0, so you will write here this is equal to 0, so theta is 90. You have to prove that these two vectors are perpendicular. So in this way you have to solve the question. Similarly, in this question, if it is given what will be the angle between a and c, look the question. If a equal to b plus c and a, b, c have their magnitudes, this you have to find the angle between a and c, then how will you write this question? Look, I am giving you this simple description. If it is given that vector a equal to vector b plus c, write a and c together because you have to find the angle between them. Then what can you write? Vector b can be written as vector a minus vector c. Now you can take the self product on both sides. That is, you can write b dot b here and here a minus c dot a minus c, and you can solve like the previous question. Do yourself. You can find this will be b square, and here you can put the values b, c, a, their magnitudes are given. Can you do yourself? Look here, this will be b square equal to, this will be a dot a, what will be a square, minus a dot c, you have to write dot product, minus c dot a, you have to write dot product, and minus minus plus, this will be c dot c, that will be c square. What are you getting? A square plus c square minus 2 a dot c. C dot a dot c both are same. So this is what is given here. B square is, you put the value 16. What is a square? You put the value 25. What is c square? You put the value 9. This is, and minus, this is 2 a dot c. How will you write a dot c? This will be a dot c. What are you getting here? This is 25 plus 9, here this is 16. This will give you 2 a dot c equal to 25 plus 9, that is 34, and minus, this is 16, so this will be 18. So A dot C will be 9. What is A dot C? AC cos theta equal to 9. Put the value A and C. A and C 5 and 3. So this is cos theta will be 9 upon 5 into 3. How much? 15. Or theta will be equal to 3 3 ja 9, 3 5 ja 5. That is theta will be cos inverse 0.6. So in this way to find the angle between them. Now this question is given in the NCRT. An object is constrained to move along z axis. It is subjected to a constant force F equal to minus I plus 2J plus 3K. If it moves 4 meter along Z axis, find the work done. You know, work done is, how to calculate work done? Work done is force and displacement, they are dot product. Then how will you calculate it orally? You know, W equal to F dot S. What is given? F minus 3i plus 2j plus 3k. And what is S? You have to assume that since the object is moving along z axis, then S you will write 4k. What is unit vector along z axis? K. You have to write yourself. Only this is the main thing. Otherwise, this F dot S you have to calculate. What is F? It is given. This is minus I plus 2J plus 3K and in dot 4K. Only since this displacement doesn't have any I and J vector, so only K and K will be multiplied. I and J are 0 here. So 4K into 3K, what will be W? Look, W will be only 12 joules. K into K 1 and this 4 into 3, this 4K into 3K, how much? 12 joule. Finally, this is the very interesting question, that if vector P dot Q equal to P dot R, can we conclude P equal to R? Look here, if P dot Q equal to P dot R, how can you write it? Look this question. This question can be written as P dot Q equal to P dot R. Bring it on LHS. You can write P dot Q vector minus R. This is, you can write here, this is P vector Q minus R. This will become 0. So what can be, you can confirm that this P vector and vector Q minus R vector, this Q minus R vector, vector Q minus vector R, this vector with P, how much, at what angle? Right angle, because this can be written as mod vector P into mod vector Q minus R into cos 90. Only then it will come 0. So you can't conclude that P will be equal to R. P may be perpendicular to this vector Q minus R. So in this way, I hope you will solve the questions based on dot product and how to find the angle between two vectors. I hope you must have enjoyed. Thank you.